Let's look at the answer to our simple barrier quiz, where we had this program where both threads are going to synchronize on a single barrier, and then thread 1 finishes, and then thread 0 continues alone. The question is, does our simple barrier implementation work for that? And the answer is yes, it does work. If we only do this barrier once, then the first thread that enters this critical section will set the release to 0 and increment the count to 1. The second thread that reaches this will increment the count to 2. If the first thread ends up waiting for release, the second one will still see that the count is 2, reset the count, set the release, and eventually, due to coherence, remember that coherence guarantees that when we read the release, eventually we'll see it. It's just that we can be arbitrarily delayed. But no matter how long we are delayed, eventually we see it. And there is no way to get stuck here. So the thread that does the releasing leaves the barrier. The releasee leaves the barrier. Or it might happen that both of them execute this in very close proximity to each other. Both of them now see the new count of 2. And then both of them release and exit the barrier. Either way, nobody gets stuck. The reason why the simpler barrier is not entirely correct is not that it doesn't work on the first try, it's that it's not reusable. So the problem occurs if we try to use this barrier again after the first time you use it, in which case somebody might be stuck still here, and we reset this so that they never leave the first instance while everybody else is in the second instance. But unless we have that second instance of the barrier, this barrier works. So in this particular case, if we are sure that we are going to use this barrier only once in the entire run of the program, then this barrier does work correctly.